How's it going, everybody? This is Dean Rojas with Epidemic Sound, and today we're gonna learn how to color grade in Premiere Pro. If you're not familiar with color grading, basically what it is it's taking your video and it's allowing you to have this creative freedom to change the hues, the saturation, to change the contrast, exposure, etc. So the difference between color correcting and color grading is that color correction is basically the precursor to color grading. It allows you to correct your footage if your highlights are a little too high, if your shadows are too high. If your blacks don't look black, then you can fix that and then make sure that your footage looks consistent, cohesive, and ready for you to put the grade on it. So I've taken a select of this beach shot for the example because I think there's a lot of good contrast in colors that's going to really show you guys the impact of a color grade. First things first is you're gonna head over here and you're gonna click New Item, and we're gonna click on Adjustment Layer. And then you're gonna click OK. So if you're color grading over a whole video, you don't wanna do it on each single clip. You wanna throw an adjustment layer on top, and then you're gonna work on the adjustment layer and not touch your footage. But if you're color correcting, then you can select each clip and change their values and so on and so forth. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna head over from editing to color. So what that's gonna do is it's gonna go ahead and open up this Lumetri color window, and we're actually gonna select our clip to add the basic corrections. So if there were multiple clips, then we would correct each one accordingly. So just for this example, we can also edit on the adjustment layer for the basic correction, but just don't get in the habit of doing that. You have your clip selected, so what I'm gonna do is, it looks a little bright up here, so I'm gonna lower the highlights just a little bit just to maintain some of the detail. And you can see there's a little cloud poking out already. I'm actually gonna bring the shadows down a bit because I wanna add a little bit more contrast on Alex over here. And then I'm gonna bring my blacks down as well, just a little bit. So if you pull up your Lumetri scopes, you're gonna get all this information, and this is basically just telling you what colors are. These are your blacks down here, and these are your whites. These are the whitest whites and the blackest blacks. So my blackest black is set to zero. And you wanna get as close to zero as possible, and with the whitest whites, you don't wanna go over 100, and I'm going over 100 here a little bit, so I'm actually gonna bring down the whites just a smidge, because it does go up over here, and you can see that right over there. So I do have absolute black, and I do have absolute white, and it's not too blown out. So that's basically as much as I'll do for a basic color correction. So then what we're gonna do is we're gonna head over to our adjustment layer, and we're actually going to skip over creative and just go straight to the curves, because these are gonna be where you're gonna be making these crucial decisions in color. So if you're unfamiliar with these curves, so this is going to affect the saturation of the hue. This is going to affect the hue itself, so what color it is. So this is going to affect the lightness or darkness of the hue. And then this is going to affect the saturation of the lightness or darkness that you select. And then this is just overall going to affect saturation. So a good place to start is to just go down the list. So hue versus saturation. So what color do I want to boost up or bring down? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select this eyedropper, and I'm gonna select these orange tones on the rock. They're kind of yellowish. And you're gonna get three plots here. And this is gonna be the color that you've chosen, and these are gonna be the two closest colors to that. So if I wanna saturate this, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hold shift, and I'm gonna click up. This orange is getting a lot more saturated. And then if I bring it down, it's going to get a lot more desaturated. So this nice line shows you the color values and where you're heading with that color. And if you wanna zero in on that color even more, you can bring these lines in. So you're only affecting this bit of orange and not affecting any colors around it. And I'm just gonna bring this up a little bit because I want it to be a little bit more saturated than it already is. It's not exactly where I want it to be. And then I'm gonna bring up the water a little bit because it's a little bit dull. So hue versus hue is where you're gonna be changing colors. And for this example, we're gonna go for an orange and teal look. A subtle one, not overdoing it. So I like to color grade with orange and teal because they're complementary colors, and orange is the most complementary of skin tones. So that's why it's used so much in cinema, and all these YouTubers edit like this too. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna pick my oranges, that I've already selected here, so I know exactly where that is, and I'm gonna change the color. So I'm gonna take this orange and I'm just gonna move it up a little bit just to kind of give it a different color. So here's the before and after. It goes from yellow to this nice, rich, bronzy orange, which already makes this clip look a lot less like mustard. It looks like mustard, but now it doesn't. It doesn't look like mustard anymore. The same thing with our blues. I'm gonna take the selector, I'm gonna click over here onto my water, and then it's gonna have that selected for me. And I'm actually gonna make this teal, so just more aqua. And then you don't wanna overdo this. It's really easy to overdo it and be like, oh, okay, cool, like, yeah, like, I'm gonna blow this out. That looks like a cool music video, but we're not going for that look. We're going for subtlety. Color grading is very subtle. It's very, very, very subtle, and it's really easy to go overboard. So you got your yellows and your royal blues, and then now we've got this little orangishness. We got a little bit of teal. It's looking nice up in the skies. It's great. So the hue versus luma. So if you want to change the lightness of the hue, this is properly exposed here. It's going to affect the brightness and darkness of the hue. So if I want to bring this blue hue down a little bit because it's too much for me, then I'm going to drag that down. But then you see, you get this noise in the background here because it's crushing the lightness and it doesn't work for everything. Be very careful when you use this. It's even more subtle than the other ones because look, I go up just a tiny bit and then I'm getting a bunch of noise in the sky again, and we do not want that. So I'm just gonna completely not apply that and not gonna use that. So what luma versus saturation is gonna do is it's you're picking a point of brightness that you're gonna choose to saturate. So it's a level of brightness where if I click over here onto this wave, it's kind of dark. Over here, it's gonna bring down those colors. So you can see areas over here that are affected by the same light level, and they're gonna get a little bit grainy over here. And then saturation versus saturation is just another saturation tool. You can eyedrop it and then select saturation on that, but it's just gonna basically be your overall image. I wouldn't touch that one either. I just stay with hue versus saturation where I can saturate other sort of hues. This one's just kind of more of a general. So for this color grade, here's the before and here's the after. All we really did was change the hue versus saturation and the hue versus hue. We didn't even touch the lumas because our clip was exposed properly, and we fixed that in the basic correction. So basically all that we did really was we color corrected this image and we bumped up the hue versus saturation and the hue versus hue in the points that we were looking to. And it looks successful, it looks nice, it looks professional, it's not overwhelming, it's very subtle. Color grading is subtle, do not overdo it. It can get real nasty real quick. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, please leave a comment, please hit subscribe, hit the notification bell, follow me on my personal channel, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Keep killing it.